over there. So.
No way to hide your lies.
hold on.
Hold on.
That was
it. Hold on, hold on.
I'm
George.
The one that screwed up.
You gotta do it again.
Why?
Because you gotta do it again.
Tell me a little bit about the radio show, George. How did that go today?
I don't know. I'm going to have to ask the people of Sarnia to see if you can get any opinions while we're in this town for the next...
I asked you a question, you asked me a question.
I'm the wrong person to ask.
Why? You're the one who did the interview.
Well, that's why you have to ask other people what they thought about.
Well, tell me emotionally. You know, how did
that's a good mission for you today, is see if you can find anybody that listened to the radio interview and what they thought about it. There you go.
Making my life as hard as can be.
officially welcome George to Sarnia. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, to thank Jim for representing the city. Tony's here representing Rumata Motel. And we want to thank him because he provided a room last night when George first arrived here in the city. George first got a hold of us back in the spring to tell us about this exciting idea of traveling across Ontario in order to raise awareness and education about organ transplants. And he chose to use the YMCAs and local communities as a medium to introduce it to communities and asked if we wanted to be involved. And of course, that was a no-brainer. He said immediately that we wanted to be involved. I got to talk to George a few times and know that he's very passionate about this whole subject, as I'm sure you'll hear in a little while from him. And we decided that, yes, we wanted to be an important part of this. And then we got a hold of somebody that I didn't introduce here, David Tolley from the Sarnia, Oregon Donors Awareness Group, and shared the idea with him, and we thought it was a good idea and really encouraged us to get involved too as well. So welcome, David, and thank you for being here. So, without further ado, let me bring up Councilman Jim Folster to welcome George on behalf of...
Thank you, Tony. Well, George, we're going to get the official part of this out of the way very quick. I'm real proud to be here representing not only Mayor Bradley and City Council, but most importantly, the people of the City of Sarnia, to welcome you here. Wish you Godspeed on the rest of your trip. Congratulate you on what you're doing and raising this awareness. And just as a little aside for yourself, let me tell you, I know exactly what the value of the awareness that you're doing is doing for the people of Canada. Because in another life, as a national chairman of a children's charity, I've met and I've hugged and I've been hugged by an awful lot of young people whose lives have been enhanced and have been extended by organ donor awareness. But by the same token, I've also met, hugged, and been hugged by some children who didn't make it because there weren't organs available. So what you're doing is the greatest thing that can be done. I want you to know, and I'm going to show you the signature, my card is signed. And I guess if there's any message to anybody out here, meet with your family, you know, talk about organ donors awareness and donating organs, and yeah, go ahead, sign that card that's with your driver's license. It can be the greatest thing that you can do for humanity, and you can leave a lasting legacy. So, again, welcome. Again, a couple of things here for you. I know that you'll probably go through a lot of t-shirts. This is our Sarnia 2000 shirt. There's some mementos here from Sarnia. So, carry on. Godspeed to you and all of that.
Thank you very much. Turn it over to you just a minute. Let me bring David Tolley up just to officially welcome you on behalf of the Sarnia Organs.
Congratulations, George. Thank you very much. You're doing a fantastic job. Our association of Sarnia has really been developed to raise the awareness level for the need for organs. I think what you're doing is fantastic. You're getting a lot more media coverage than we are, and you're getting it free. What can be better than that? With the number of people right now waiting for organs in Ontario, we're obviously, it looks like we're losing the battle of getting people informed, but I think we're the more...
In my job, the most interesting individuals and the most rewarding people, and I was most impressed with George and what he's trying to accomplish. I have a cousin who has had 3 kidney transplants, so in our family, I have a pretty good idea of what an individual goes through and what George is trying to accomplish. So it means something to me also, George. So on behalf of the Y and health and fitness and us healthy people that work out every day and have that benefit of being healthy, we should be very, very thankful. And we're very thankful to George to be able to create this awareness so other people who don't have the benefit of good health can eventually become like some of the people here and be very healthy and productive and loving citizens and all that neat kind of stuff. So welcome to the Y. And we have a couple of t-shirts here. Now that the weather's getting cold, we figured we don't want to freeze on your way to Windsor, I believe you're going. Can't strip anymore, no. Where are you going? You know,
well, sometimes it's
great fundraiser. Anyhow, a couple of sweatshirts, Y sweatshirts
everybody for coming here. I'm glad that Tony did mention everybody, because I remember the last press conference, I forgot one group, and I just felt so bad, you know. So I want to really veto everybody that he thanked for being here today. And I want to especially just take this moment to acknowledge the YMCA's part. Because it's just been phenomenal, incredible, and it's really been effective in reaching the heart of each community that we passed through. And you know, while I was going from YMCA to YMCA, everybody kept saying, when are you going to get to Sarnia? Because, you know, I kept talking about, well, we have a really nice facility here. And he said, well, wait till you get to Sarnia. And I must have heard that from hundreds of people. And you know what? I got here, and this is a beautiful place. I mean, this is just great. Joe, you got to make sure you get shots of every part of the building.
I just blew my whole footage.
I want to also share some of the things that, some of the conclusions, more or less, that we've been arriving to as we've been going from community to community on our trek to keep here. We have our voice gets stronger like this. The rest of Canada is looking at this, and they feel more comfortable with the spirit of organ transplantation. So step by step, we'll get there. Thank you very much.
My name is David Tully. I'm the chairman of the Sarnia Organ Donor Awareness Group. We call it the SODA Group for short. We founded this group in Sarnia because a few of us went through the process of having a transplant. Now, in my particular case, I've had a double lung transplant. One of the other folks with us had a double lung and heart transplant. And another person was on a kidney transplant waiting list. And what we went through, at the time we were going through it, we found out that it was a severe lack of awareness in the Sarnia area. And therefore, we felt it was probably all across Ontario and Canada in general, that people, through no fault of their own, are just not aware of the real need for organ donors. As it stands right now, with the number of people in Ontario that are waiting for this operation, for whatever organ is necessary, it even makes groups like ourselves more necessary to operate and get out there and spread the word for the need for organ donation. I had my transplant in December of 93. From the day that I had my transplant till now, I've counted myself as one of the very lucky people that was able to have a lifelong problem cured, even if it was only for 1 or 2 days. And in fact, now it's been 5 years. So I don't know what percentage that puts me in of these lucky candidates, that are lucky people are still surviving. But each and every day, I thank God that I've been given another chance to be here. And in trying to repay that, I've tried to put as much time as I can back into the Sarnia Organ Donor Awareness Group. At the time of my operation, I had been off work for about 2 years, and I was put on a waiting list, which unfortunately in Ontario You go on a waiting list when you're really at the end of the line to speak, really to put it in blunt terms. There's no other hope for you, so you're on a waiting list, and with the luck of God and the hope of your family and the prayers of everybody, you will receive a organ from another person that has passed away.
For your...
I was one of the very lucky people that actually waited on the waiting list for 1 month. But in reality, I waited for 45 years. This is how long I had the problem. And since I've had this, went on the waiting list, I had been on the oxygen hose for approximately 6 to 8 months before that. So, each and every day that I was in that situation on an oxygen machine, I sometimes think of that now when I wonder if we're doing any good as a group, because I know the people now that are on waiting lists are, in fact, their quality of life is terrible. In fact, some people are looking at a death sentence, that if they do not get an organ within a prescribed time, they will undoubtedly die. There are other people, in the case of kidney needs, that are on dialysis, which just takes away from your quality of life completely. Hooked up to a machine, there's two or three different ways to have it, but hooked up to a machine in every day, this is not a good way to live. It's another point why we feel we have to go out and make sure that the people are at least aware of the need for organ donation.
So what would you like to talk to the ambulance?
I think if I had a chance to go on a national TV show and tell everybody at one time how I feel about the organ donation and what it could mean to the country, I would start getting people in that are on the waiting list. I would let the rest of Canada see the suffering and the pain that these people are going through. Then I would bring in some people that have had the operation, have had the transplant, and let the rest of Canada once again see that these people can come back and lead a productive life. They can go back to their old jobs in many cases, or they can continue to help out and do, with their family. The big thing is your family still has you. And I think we're all, as compassionate Canadians, very sensitive to that.
If you could say anything to the donor family, or all donor families that have donated, what would that be?
In my case, I've tried to contact the donor family. I've sent them a letter and in fact never received a reply. I'm told by the people at University Hospital London that this isn't unusual. But I would say to all donor families that, thank you, thank you, thank you, that you have given one of the most precious gifts that anybody on the face of the earth can give. It's an unfortunate fact that we all on the face of this earth will at some point in time die, either through natural causes or through accidental death. And if, in the case of death, if we can leave an ongoing legacy and help another person, I don't think there's any greater gift than that a person can get involved in. So I would say to all donor families, thank you very much. And all potential donor families, please consider this very carefully, and hopefully you will agree to it.
Back even for the first 3 years, I wrote every year on the anniversary of my transplant. You can't sign your name on it, and you can't send it yourself. You send it to the Steve in London, social worker,
right.
And And you send it to him, and then he forwards it on, and I've never had a reply back.
Would you like to meet them?
I'd love to, yeah.
So George is trying to work on a mutual consent kind of thing, mm-hmm. where both parties, if they wanted to, would that be all right?
Oh, it would be, absolutely, because when I first got my transplant, after I thought I could hear this person's voice.
Right.
And every time I thought about it, I thought maybe he had grandkids and mm-hmm. and they've lost him, and because I have his liver now, mm-hmm. that I'm alive and he's not.
But he's living through you.
That's right now. And yeah. I would like them to know how successful it was, and my quality of life is great.
How long did it take you on the waiting list to get a liver?
I had the beeper for a year, 1 week less a year. Before that, though, I had been sick for about 29 or 30 years.
Yeah.
And at the very end, I was really sick. I was so sick I couldn't hardly leave the house. My husband George would say, do you want to go for a little drive? And I'd say, okay. And we'd go out of the house, and I'd get to the car, and I'd have to go back in. I couldn't go. So
it was... how did the transplant...
After I had the transplant on Good Friday, the 13th, 1990, mm-hmm. and 2 days later, I was standing up at the sink washing my hair, helping the nurse wash my hair. So that's my quality. That's how it started for me. And I'm not one of these people who wait for anything. I want to get it done tomorrow, yesterday rather, And I did. Like, I just kept pushing and pushing and pushing, and I wouldn't let them do anything for me. I said, this is my favorite saying, I want to do it myself. And so they let me too, pretty much. And the first time to go down to have a shower by yourself, I went down there, and then I guess I was a little long coming back, and they all thought that, and then I sat and I couldn't reach, I was too tired and I couldn't reach the buzzer. Finally I did, and then they all came running thinking that I'd hurt myself somehow to the room. So. That's how weak you are afterwards, but then each day is an improvement, and before you know it, you're back to yourself. They say don't lift a chair, don't even lift your teapot, you know, bring the kettle, one cup. Well, who wants to do that, you know? So. Well, you know, you do what you want to do, and I think that's good. I don't think everybody's the same. They say don't do anything for 6 months. Well, I don't think that's true for everybody. And if you want to do it in 3 months or 2 months, do it. The only thing I found hard to do was vacuuming, and I didn't do that for a while, but other than that, I did everything else. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell Canadians about transplantation?
I would just like to tell everyone that it's just a shame that everyone doesn't sign their card and give this gift of life to people, because it's so needed. And I went to a gift of life service in Niagara Falls a year after I had my transplant, and I'll never forget it. There was little kids, and they all carried candles, and there was adults, and there was this one mother who spoke. Her 16-year-old daughter had gone skiing, and on the way back, she hadn't had her driver's license very long, but she lost control of her car, and she only lived a few days. While she was in the hospital, and she was in a coma, they asked her about organ donation, and she's, oh God, no, I couldn't do that. But the sister, a couple years older, said, Mom, her and I can't remember the girl's name now, we discussed it, and she wanted to have her organs donated. So then they reconsidered, and they gave the 7 organs, and she said the only thing she couldn't give away were the eyes, but 7 other people got the gift of life, and they're living just from that one person. So everyone should do it.
What would you like to say to your family?
I would just like to say thank you and God for the gift of life that I have. I got to see my grandkids grow up, and here I am. I would just like to someday shake their hand and thank them for their wonderful gift. My name is Evelyn Smith. Welcome.
Slater Lockery.
And you are a transplant recipient?
Yes, September 2nd, 95. 4 years ago, a little over 4 years ago.
How long did you have to wait to receive?
About 15 years before I actually got my transplant.
And you were put on the list 15 years ago?
No, I was put on the list 3 years before.
3 years, so you waited 3 years on the list?
Yeah.
And, were you really sick before you, how was you, what happened to you?
I got hepatitis C. Right. And the doctors in Sarnia here couldn't figure out what it was. So they finally sent me to London, and the doctors down in London figured it out right away what it was. So they tried chemically treating me, and to some success, but not good enough. So they finally put me on the transplant list. And I had one no-go. I was right on the table. And then the liver turned out to be no good. So I went back to the room and try again.
How did that make you feel?
Scary. Because you don't know when that second one, or if that second one is going to come.
Have you written a letter to your organ donor family?
No, I discussed it with Patsy Burns in London. She was my caseworker in London. And under the circumstances, she's a lot of them don't want to hear from you.
Well, that's her opinion.
That was her opinion.
What would be your opinion? What would you like to?
I would like to at least write them a letter and thank them for what they've done. Because of the transplant, I've been able to watch my daughter grow up, still be around.
So life is much better.
Much better.
What would you like to tell the community people watching about transplant and donations?
Sign that donor card and make it known to your family and friends of your wishes, so that when the time comes, they'll know. Give the organs.
My name's Diane Schultz, and I just want to say a couple of words, I guess, about the organ donor transplant people and the people that I've met today. My cousin has received 3 kidney transplants over her lifetime. Currently, her last kidney is not functioning. She can't have another transplant. So as a family member, we have seen the trials and tribulations of what Vicky's gone through. It's been very, very difficult. She's had a lot of ups and many more downs, but she has been so fortunate to get the kidneys that she has, and in her good period of life, things worked very well for her. So I have a different perspective. I've seen what the family's gone through, I've seen what the recipient's gone through. Both my husband and I have signed our donor cards. I can't imagine anything better than giving the gift of life to someone else. We've heard we're all on this earth for just a short period of time, so if we can leave something, a legacy behind, and someone else can see their grandchildren or their children grow up, or if it's a young child and that young child can grow to be a teenager and a productive citizen and do great things in their life, what better way to be able to do that than to give an organ to someone in need? So I would like to very much recommend to everybody and strongly suggest to people to think a little, step back, have a look, put yourself in that recipient's shoes, and think of what it must be like to be on the other side of the fence. And please sign the donor card.
Sou diretor-geral do YMCA na cidade de Sarnia. Hoje eu gostava de falar com vocês num caso muito importante. Aqui que a gente hoje temos um senhor Jorge Marcelo e o senhor José Camara, que têm espantando a educar a população do Antártico num caso que é muito, muito importante e um caso que vai...
stop.
Vai para a vida de famílias e amigos do nosso continente. O caso é de transplantar de órgãos do coração, dos pulmões, dos rins e do fígado e dos olhos. E tem muitas pessoas que têm esperando e só precisa dos órgãos para dar vida. Pense isso muito bem, só para dar vida. E quando a gente morre, a gente pode deixar esses órgãos para alguma pessoa e dar vida. E isso é a mais grande oferta que a gente pode fazer a uma outra pessoa. Só lembra-se que nós todos somos uma comunidade e que nós todos vamos precisar desses órgãos. E a gente quer que vocês pensem na necessidade dos irmãos e as irmãs que vão precisar disso para dar vida. E é muito simples vocês. Pode-se assinar o nosso cartão de chofer e permitir os órgãos a alguém que precisa. E na nossa morte, talvez a gente pode dar vida. Isso é uma grande oferta. E isso lembra as palavras de Jesus. O que a gente faz, o que eles estão precisando, é a coisa mais grande e a gente faz no nome dele. Muito obrigada e quero dar os parabéns ao Sr. Jorge Marcelo e ao Sr. José Camara e a gente quer desejar o melhor e no nosso grande caso e que o Deus vá em com eles.
Ramada Hotel there. Tony there give us a couple of nights.
That's good.
Yeah.
Find that response is going over well?
Yeah, actually the media here is overwhelmed. They're doing a special on the Observer for tomorrow.
Okay.
And the radio station's been, and the people of Sarnia are really grasping the message that we're sending. Yeah, yeah. Being that the YMCA is a big part of the community here. And then your restaurant, Kelsey's here, and then the Ramon. So we got to touch a lot of people out here. Yeah.
Today is September the 11th, and we're here in Sarnia. And once again, Kelsey has come through in contributing a meal, which will carry us during our next venture to Chatham. And I really want to take this time and an opportunity to say thank you very much. Kelsey, all along the way, have been feeding us, and that's what's making this trip possible.
That's good.
Thank you. Glad we support you. Thank you very much.
Today,
12 until 8 p.m. We'll be over here to the right of the stage signing posters for $5 immediately following this afternoon's concert. Also wanted to mention somebody here who's here for a very worthwhile cause. Ladies and gentlemen, if you just want to look to the right of the stage here, he's got his foot up there. George Marcello, just give a wave here. George is a liver transplant recipient who is doing a walk across Ontario to bring more awareness to the very, very big importance of organ donation. So George, congratulations. We had it on the Fox on Friday, and we had a special news conference and whatnot, so George will be back. He'll be back here to town. But anyway, if you want to help out, the Sarnia Organ Donor Awareness Branch, they're located in Northgate, so George. Fox FM in the city of Sarnia proudly presenting Spice!
nothing for me, baby. If you can't dance, if you can't dance, if you can't dance, if you can't dance, if you can't dance to this, you can't do nothing for me, baby. If you can't dance, if you can't dance, if you can't dance, if you can't dance, if you can't dance to this, you can't do nothing for me, baby.
Sorry.
Press it again, that shuts it off. Press it again. Ashton does the dancing.
Everybody gather.
We're gathered.
I want to do the dance, jump in thing.
I got you on stage already. You're pretty,
I'll
send you some footage. I got you guys all on stage. I'll send you some footage.
Cool, that's great. Yeah. Do you have the address for the company?
Everyone except
Shall we do a line? Cool. I mean, make a line?
Shall we do a line? Yeah.
Make a semicircle.
Okay.
That's class.
I said semicircle.
Not really a circle, right? Yeah. Try to get it as natural as possible, right? You know what I mean?
Hey,
James.
Well, at this point, no, but if he doesn't do anything at that point, what I'm going to do in May of 2000 is walk across the country. And at that point, we're going to have petitions, and I'm going to start raising funds to get a national registry.
Can we give you our email address?
Absolutely.
And then keep us in mind. Yeah,
give it to me right on the camera if you'd like.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. All right.
The other reason why my road manager makes suggestions like that.
You guys were fantastic.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Close your eyes, you think spicy.
All right, so our email address is spicetrip@hotmail.com. All right, so anybody who wants to write us there, that's where we are, that's where you can find us.
SPICETRIP.
That's right.
That's us.com. So you can keep us informed through that, and we can keep you informed where we are.
All the good news, because that little girl was the only good news that we heard along the
way. Yeah, that's great.
I'm telling you, though, once they hear that you guys are involved in this too, it's just.
Boom.
Open up a whole new dimension.
Oh, absolutely. Well, we're happy to help. Right. Yeah, yeah, let us know whatever we can do.
We're putting your poster on our trailer.
So all right. Along the highway. Oh, that's exciting for us, too.
Great. Well, it's nice to be known as somebody who can
absolutely.
Who can help.
Absolutely.
For sure. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, it was so touching in North Bay. Like, sorry.
I don't want to meet them.
That was a large crowd. And I you guys don't hang around to hear the impact afterwards.
No, we never do.
I heard that you guys were sensational, and you probably hear that a lot of times.
Yes, he tells me.
Well, then we're gonna have to see you more often. That's all.
Great.
You know what? I know that's probably a hit around the corner. It's probably gonna be just around the corner, and that video is going to appear pretty soon.
Yeah.
You guys are phenomenal. On this
You're too. Great.
Even your ad libbing. Like,
there was plenty of that.
Oh, many.
Well, that's
because most of it is
ad-lib. Like, yeah. And we get a load of flack from the management and from the rest of the band.
We
stop
did.
Talking.
We get
stop
talking.
Talking.
Exactly.
We get so much trouble.
That's what makes the show.
Me as a fan loves that part. So maybe I'll talk to you.
Yeah. Have a little chat.
That's right.
Add an extra 5 minutes to the
yeah,
show.
Yeah, just so they could talk.
And even
over each other.
See the guy with the curly hair over there, Joe.
He never lets us talk.
He never lets us talk.
They like it when we talk.
That's right. They like it.
I can bring you a petition. Hundreds of thousands of other people that like it.
He won't agree with you. There's no use.
If he's very stubborn,
we have friends all over North America. And if we get something on the email and just say, pass it on, and we do. You know, and then send it back.
We could send it to all of the people we have registered in our address book.
Oh, no. Yep. Mm-hmm. Great.
Send it
That's
out.
That's fantastic. Thank you.
Absolutely. Do.
Would you like to meet
it's
the boys?
And it's yes. Done for us. Yes.
Yes.
Boys. Yes. Meet the boys.
They're all from T.O., aren't they?
Yeah, we're from T.O.
T.O.
All right. Great. My name's Marshall. Your name?
Marshall George.
Paul.
Paul. Nice to meet you.
Sorry, I'm Mark.
Hi, Mark.
How's it going?
Hi,
nice to meet you.
Gary, how you doing? This guy looks like
the
wrestler.
Rock.
The Rock.
You smell what the Rock.
Steve Austin, by the way.
Spooky.
Fight.
He's going to fight now.
God bless you.
There's Steve Austin over there.
Give me a hell yeah, boys.
Like I was saying to the girls here, you guys are, I caught you guys on Saturday. And that was when that little girl drew the water, needed a bone. We raised over 8,000 signatures. Last week, she got the ball.
We signed that thing when they came through the back.
Yeah.
The girl came through the back. We signed it.
So, she's recovering. You know, things
that's why I'm doing this walk. Because I needed an organ. I needed a liver. In 92, they found something in my blood. They said I was going to die. And I only had 3 years left to live. And I was against all the odds, believe me. So I got a call from the hospital in 95. They said there was an organ available. I will help in that operation. And you know what was on my mind? I was, you know, getting a new birth here, but a family was facing a tragedy that year. It was going through a tragedy because, you know, that's what it takes. You know, it takes, but we're trying to create a spirit here with people. We're trying to create, to stimulate the spirit of transplantation. And there wasn't enough of it in Canada. It's been the lowest in the world in 14 years. So that's why I'm doing this walk. And when I seen you guys in North Bay, I go, you know what, I'm going to dog Gary down until I get because you guys are a perfect fit to help reach this younger generation of people. You know? So, you know, we're talking about saving lives even today. You know, I mean, just even that announcement could possibly save a life. I mean, you know, people are left with a good feeling about this when they hear from people like yourself. Me and Gary are going to get together, and possibly the third week or fourth week of October, we're going to see if we can put something together at Hyde Park. And
we as a group appreciate the fact that you chose us.
No problem. I've been following my heart because there was a lot of other groups that but my heart, it just pointed to you and it kept pointing and pointing, and I always follow my heart. You know, sometimes your head's saying, well, what are you, stupid? Well, you know, it's not, you know, you're not going to get, this guy's got so many things to do and so many, you know. But I listen to my heart, you know, and I feel really good about where you guys are doing and where you guys are heading.
Are you guys going to write anything original?
It's around the corner, right?
Yeah, because you guys have a quality voices, man. Really good. I enjoy it.
You guys are exceptional on that.
They'll just hire me to play.
My show. Hey, you're in.
You guys got it.
Thank you.
It's sure good dancing, too, guys.
And you guys are still in school while you're doing this, right?
Oh, yeah. We're actually finished.
Oh, did you? Oh, okay.
George,
it's hard to be. I mean, it's hard to be on university at 17.
Wear that around your neck and you get in.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Can I get your schedule?
Because we'll follow you.
Can I get your schedule?
Sure.
I'll hobble along and wherever you guys go.
George, I don't even have one of those. I don't even have one of those.
You don't get one of those.
Really? Yes.
That's fine, though. That's fine. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but you don't know what I've had to do to get track this guy down. He's a good guy, though. So on the 30th, we're going to be walking right into breakfast television on the 30th of September. And then we're scheduled to be acknowledged at Queen's Park. And I'll be having a conference with the Premier Harris because we really want the government to get involved in this. And what we want to do is create a national registry where, you know, when people 18 and over, if they have a wish to donate their organs, it'll get registered and get carried out. Right now, what happens is, even if you sign your donor card, at the hospital, the hospital official approaches the family, and 60% of the time, the family vetoes the decision because we have a wrong picture there. You know, asking the family at a time of tragedy is not the right.
It's not fair.
It's not fair.
It's not fair to the family. It's not fair to the person that has the problem.
Exactly. So we're way behind in the other countries when it comes to this. And some of them have national registries, and they're enjoying success. So I'm going to walk across the country in May to raise funds to make sure we get this national registry. So we might be bumping into each other along your tours.
As far as that walk, a couple of blocks, That's a bit of time.
3,000 miles.
I see what you guys do on the stage, and that's a pretty good workout, man. So you guys are probably busy, and
packing up, head back.
What's your next gig?
Next Saturday at the Capitol Theater in Windsor.
In Windsor, next Saturday.
It's gonna be step by step day, man.
You know what? I seen you guys. I mean, we were in the same schedule with North Bay, with Wawa. with here. And now Windsor, I'm getting, as a matter of fact, on Friday, Windsor's calling it George Marcello Day. Okay, I gotta talk to Gary about this.
All right,
starting something.
We're starting something.
Here we go. Cool.
Maybe if you guys can make it out there, okay, let me talk.
Yeah. Well, we'll definitely be there on Saturday.
Yeah.
So if you guys can make it out,
we'll be there.
Well, like I said, this ain't gonna stop me. I'm gonna hop all along the highway.
Crazy,
I got 1,800 kilometers done already, and I got 200 left to go. So.
1,800 kilometers.
Yeah. That I walked in Toronto.
No joke, eh? And how do you like? What do you do? Like, where do you sleep tonight?
Tonight we got the Romero Insta, Joe.
I don't know, we haven't been evicted yet.
Oh, okay, we haven't been.
Excellent!
Yeah, there's hotels that have been just taking us in. Wendy's been feeding us, Pizza Hut's been feeding us.
Really, eh?
Yeah, we started with $1,200.
Nice. That's great.
Lean, fire machine, whatever they got.
Amen.
Cool. Okay, so. I'll catch you guys on Saturday.
Thanks,
buddy. Appreciate
talking to you.
Thanks a lot. You guys,
like,
phenomenal. I'll keep saying
that.
Everybody. Thanks a lot.
All right. Catch you later, George. See you, man.
Okay.
Bye.